The topic that we are now going to put on discussion is how to determine whether or not to use the Coriolis coefficient in estimating the pipe system coefficient of resistance. For the determination of a pump operating mode, it's necessary to know its operating point at the current operating conditions. The operating point is the intersect between the pump head curve and the pipe system resistance curve, the red and blue lines respectively, like shown in this simple diagram. To begin with, it's necessary to classify basically the different types of pipes. In general, they can be classified into two groups. Group 1 contains simple or complex pipes, while group 2 contains short or long pipes. According to their main definitions, simple pipe can be defined as a single pipe or a composition of pipes of the same or different diameter, but no branches. A complex pipe can be any pipe having branches. Short pipes are those where the minor, or also called local resistance, energy loss represents at least 20% of the total energy loss. It's an official standard, but you can use it. Long pipes are those where the most significant part of the total energy loss comes as a result of friction. In this case, the minor energy loss can be neglected or just added as a percentage in the range of 5 to 10 from the friction, or also called Mayer energy loss. The resistance curve of a simple pipe represents the graphical relationship between the head energy loss HV, or the pressure drop delta PV, and the flow rate Q, which is given in equation 1. The pipe system resistance curve represents a parabola, which can be described by equation 2. Equation 3 is used to estimate the head energy loss in the pipe system, and now is applied in calculating the coefficient K of resistance. To determine the final equation used to estimate K, it is necessary to pre-use the relationship between the velocity and flow rate obtained from the continuity equation. And this is presented in equation 4. Equation 5 represents the option in general for estimating the coefficient K of a simple pipe system resistance curve. However, it must be taken into account that sometimes it has to be modified so that the Coriolis coefficient alpha is involved. A typical example can be each opened end pipe system, like the one presented in the sample diagram on the next slide. To explain this modification requires the applying of Bernoulli's equation in form of head and for real fluids for two specific cross sections selected as demonstrated on the sample diagram. In order to understand when, how, and why the equation used for calculating the coefficient K of the pipe system resistance curve is modified, it is necessary to consider the scheme presented on this slide. Bernoulli's equation is used for real fluid flows, for the application of which two sections are pre-selected. These are the sections 1-1, representing the free level of liquid in the tank, and 2-2, representing the pipe outlet, like shown in this figure. After the section selection is performed, the next step to do is to specify their specific parameters, such as absolute pressure P, average velocity V, and geodetic height Z. The absolute pressure P1 in section 1.1 may be presented as a sum of the atmospheric and manometric ones, while the absolute pressure P2 in section 2.2 is equal to the atmospheric one, because the liquid leaves the pipe free and leaks in the atmosphere. The two velocities, V1 for section 1.1, will be equal to zero, it is reliable, and V2 for section 2.2, that is equal to the average velocity of the liquid while being transported through the pipe, are also specified. For the determination of the geodetic height, it is taken into account that the section 2.2 is closer to the Earth, so Z2 will be zero, and therefore Z1 will be h, where h is the distance between the two sections. Then, since the total energy losses in the pipe system are involved in Bernoulli's equation, they need to be calculated according to the following equation, this one. Next step is to use the Bernoulli's equation and to replace the relevant parameters that were previously described. It is presented on the slide. So here is the Bernoulli equation, and just below you can see the replacing. After eliminating the unnecessary members of the equation and do the relevant mathematical transformation, the following equation that you see below is obtained, where Pm divided with the multiplication of rho and g plus h, the small one, is the system head, due to the reason that water transportation, in this case, is performed from higher to lower level. There should be plus in front of h. This is something important that should be taken into account. However, it is known that the system head, the big H, may also be estimated as follows. Just see the equation below. Therefore, the following relationship is found. By taking into account that the flow average velocity may be presented, expressed by the flow rate Q, the following equation is obtained. So this is the modified version of the final equation that has to be used for the estimation of the pipe system resistance curve coefficient K. The most important now, as can be seen, in this case, the Coriolis coefficient should be involved in the equation used to estimate the resistance coefficient. This is the main difference comparing the two studied cases. Now is to focus your attention on one more exception from the general form of this equation used to estimate a simple pipe system coefficient of resistance, which is in case of studying concerning long pipe. Just remember what was important for the long pipes, indicating that the minor energy loss in a long pipe represents insignificant part of the total energy loss, which means that it can be neglected. The following equation for the estimation of K may be used. So below you can see the transformation. So taking into account that there will be almost zero minor energy loss, and after transforming the initial form of the equation mathematically, the final modified version of this equation is obtained and presented at the end of this slide. The meaning of all symbolic designations, in other words, symbols, involved in the equations of this presentation is described in the comment below the video. Thank you for watching.